Welcome back to County Connection. For this segment, we are going to be focusing on flu season and how you can protect yourself from the flu. And with us to shed light on this topic is public health nurse Jill Brenner. Welcome, Jill.
Thank you.
All right, so we are quickly, flu season is upon us.
Sure is.
And so can you start off by defining the flu? Because sometimes you hear people using the flu to describe a lot of different conditions, but why don't you give us the expert definition?
Okay, sure. So the flu, influenza virus, it's a virus, and it's a respiratory illness, and it kind of breeds in the lungs, and it's spread through the air when anybody talks, sneezes, or coughs.
Okay.
So it's highly contagious.
So it is a really, and a touch of the flu is another misnomer that if you do actually contract influenza, then you get knocked down pretty hard, typically.
Correct.
Okay. Yeah.
Provided, too, that you have not had your flu vaccine.
Right. what do we know so far about, are there any predictions about flu season this year and how bad it might be?
Really, it's difficult to predict any flu season. Flu is a virus that is constantly changing, and we cover ourselves by getting the flu shot, but it may not exactly cover the exact strain that is introduced.
And when can we expect flu activity to begin in a typical year?
So it's fairly unpredictable, but generally speaking, you would want to plan for, it can come around as early as September.
Okay.
And it can leave as late as May.
So with all a variety of strains possibly kind of taking root in the population, how do we know if the vaccine that we're getting in a flu shot will be a good match for the virus that we happen to be facing?
Right. So there are multiple valents of vaccines available. And, scientists are doing their best to try to match what they're seeing, what the theme is, kind of what they're seeing come up in terms of the virus. And, we're building antibodies all the time. And so if we get the flu shot, that's helping our bodies to build those antibodies against the virus. So it kind of mimics, when we get the flu shot, it mimics and it makes our bodies think that we're going to get the flu.
Right, but so. In a kind of a small, safe dose.
Right,
okay.
Right. 0.5 mils to be exact.
Okay. Yeah. and so even if the strains that are contained in the flu shot aren't a precise match, there still is value to getting that flu shot. Is that right?
Correct. As we know, we might be couch bound for about a week once we contract the flu. Again, provided we haven't had a flu vaccine. If we do receive a flu vaccination, let's say we get the flu vaccine in early October, and we might contract a minimal case of the flu in maybe February, let's say. There might have been a new strain introduced or that arrived in our community that valent of vaccine didn't totally cover completely. However, I want to make it very known that you can still be covered in that your symptoms are less severe.
Okay.
And it makes it less severe and not as bad as if you were to have the flu.
Okay.
The so, full flu without the vaccine.
So less awful.
Yes.
All right. So are there risks associated with the flu vaccine from an injection? Can people get sick or contract the flu? Because there's chunks of flu viruses or molecules of some sort in there, right? So, so can you talk a little bit about that?
Sure. So it's actually, and what you're referring to, so there, basically when scientists are in their labs trying to figure out this virus, they're using a live virus, but they kill the virus before it's packaged into the multi-vial or the single dose vials. Mm-hmm. So it, essentially it's a dead virus that you're receiving. It is, you cannot get the flu from getting the flu shot. That has been scientifically just proven not possible.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then how about folks with egg allergies? Sometimes you hear mm-hmm. concerns about from folks who have that allergy of whether or right. not they should get a flu right. shot.
And I respect the fact that you're telling us that, you know, you might have an egg allergy and you don't want to get the flu because of that. However, per the CDC, you can still safely receive the flu vaccine, and that is if you just have hives locally or even body hives, and if you're able to take a Benadryl, you can do that as well. But it's if you have what's called angioedema, swelling of the airway, or anything that severe, then it's you can still safely actually get the flu shot, but you want to be in an environment, a medical environment, where you know you can be safely observed for maybe an hour or so, and
okay,
and be around a provider that knows you. And well, the CDC recommends that you get a flu shot every season, and again, that's anywhere from as soon as we get the flu and once it becomes available in our community, as early as mid-September typically is when we're starting to see stock of the flu come into our community. So, so again, the CDC recommends you get a flu shot every season, and that would protect you as well as protecting others around you. And you know, simple things like when you cough, they call it the vampire cough, you know, put your, don't use your hands and put your arm into your, or your face into your elbow. Wash your hands as much as possible during flu season. Wash your hands all the time, actually. and also stay home when you're ill. That would protect you as well as others again.
All right. So where and when can people get flu shots in Summit County?
So, a lot of places, pharmacies, doctor's offices, employers may arrange a clinic with public health. So I work with public health, and we give flu shots there as well. And we have a walk-in clinic on Mondays from 1 to 4:30 on Mondays. And we're happy to give flu shots during that time.
Okay. And is that year-round, or that you have your walk-in clinic on Monday afternoons?
It is.
Okay, great.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So we talked about when during the year to get a flu shot, so as early as possible, right. So in the fall.
Right.
And but how about when in your lifespan? So mm-hmm. when we arrive sure. on the planet, when, yeah. when, how old should we be when we have our first flu shot?
Right. So they say, per the CDC, they say to start as early as 6 months. And at 6 months, we offer a two-dose series for the first flu shot ever. So it's just a less dose that they're receiving.
Okay.
At 0.2 milliliters versus 5. So it's in two series.
Okay.
Two, five,
so it's
I'm sorry.
Spread out over two
yes.
different dates.
Correct.
Okay.
And then, you know, up to as long as you want. We do offer high dose for individuals 65 and older.
Okay.
For those that might be immunocompromised. But at 65, it's just recommended in general to get the high dose, because our immunities just aren't as strong once we hit 65 and 70 and
okay.
thereafter. So.
Okay. Let's see, is there anything that we haven't covered in terms of making sure that we're prepared for flu season?
One thing I did want to say about the flu mist is that I know it's unfortunate, but I was just reading the CDC recently, and they did say that they're going to try to have it come back.
Okay.
So no fear, you know, they'll work on it diligently, I'm sure, and it should be offered again in the future, but definitely not this season.
So. Okay. All right. And lastly, Jill, how can folks get in touch with you or anyone else at the public health team if they want more information on this topic?
Sure. So I can be reached at, and can I give a phone number?
Sure.
Yeah. So my number is 970-668-9707. And Nursing Supervisor Sarah Lopez can also be contacted at 970-668-9709. And our general office number is 970-668-9161.
Okay, great. So. And then people can visit your office. Can you let folks know where they can find you?
Sure. So we're located in the MOB, the Medical Offices Building, attached to the hospital, and it's 360 Peak One Drive. And we actually are so if you walk in the main entrance of the MOB, we are the second floor up. You can take the elevator or take the stairs up, and then you just turn down the hall to the right, and then we're the first door on the left.
Perfect.
Yeah.
All right. Well, thanks very much, Jill, for coming in today.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Definitely.
Yeah.
All right. Stick with us. We're going to take a quick break, and when we come back, we're going to be talking about financial assistance for childcare.